In this next video, we'll talk about a specific category of molecule that controls the chemical reactions within the cell. We'll be discussing enzymes. In our last video, we were discussing different categories of chemical reactions, including exergonic reactions which release energy. Recall, in chemical reactions, the molecules you have before the reaction take place are known as the reactants. The molecules after the reaction takes place are the products. Now, even if a reaction will be releasing energy and thereby making your system more stable, sometimes there's an initial investment of energy that must be given, and this is known as activation energy. So some chemical reactions need a jumpstart to proceed. And the name given to that energy that must be invested is called activation energy, or the energy of activation. So in this chemical reaction, where glucose and oxygen are going to react together to give off energy, again, energy is being released, but first an initial amount of energy must be given. This activation energy can actually limit the onset or the beginning of this chemical reaction. Catalysts are substances that speed up chemical reactions. They often do this by reducing the amount of activation energy required for that particular reaction to proceed. Now, the amazing thing about catalysts is that they are not consumed or used up during that chemical reaction. In fact, the catalyst is still there and it can be used over and over again to continue to speed up that particular chemical reaction. Enzymes are biological catalysts. Usually, these are proteins within the cell. The way these catalysts work is that they lower the energy of activation. And in this way, they can increase the speed of the chemical reaction. So in this particular diagram, you can imagine the reactants are these energy-rich molecules represented here as water at the top of a hill. And the only thing that's really holding it back is the activation energy. It's sort of acting as a dam or a barrier, preventing that water from flowing down. Well, if we can reduce the height of that activation energy barrier, we see a lot more of the reactants will be able to make it over that barrier, and therefore the chemical reaction will proceed more quickly. Now, how is it that enzymes are able to do this? So one thing that's important to realize is that enzymes are very specific for the reactions in which they're able to impact. Enzymes typically are only able to allow one particular type of chemical reaction to occur at a faster rate. And this is because the three-dimensional shape of the enzyme is what gives it its ability. It's the shape that determines the function. Now, there's a region on the enzyme which is known as the active site. The active site is a binding site for a specific type of molecule known as the substrate. The substrate is usually the reactants of this particular chemical reaction. It is the shape of the active site that determines which substrates can bind to that enzyme. The molecules that bind to the enzyme are called the substrate. As I had mentioned, these are normally the reactants. Of the chemical reaction, the shape of the enzyme is specific for the substrate that it affects. This is often described as a lock and key mechanism, whereas the active site for the enzyme will only hold particular shaped substrates, and it's the way that those substrates are positioned next to each other that allows the chemical reaction to occur more quickly. In this particular example, the two substrates are A and B, and the flat sides of those molecules have to come in contact with each other in order for the chemical reaction to proceed. Well, the enzyme is able to do this because as soon as it comes in contact with A and B, it positions them properly. And then, after the chemical reaction has occurred, it releases the product and the enzyme can be used again. Because each enzyme is specific for one particular reaction, and thousands of chemical reactions are occurring in each cell each minute, cells need to have thousands of different enzymes. To perform the work of life. Another thing that we'll see, which is true for our body, is that we have metabolic pathways. A metabolic pathway is a series of chemical reactions in which one after the other, these chemical reactions must occur to get the final product. There often will be several intermediate steps within these metabolic pathways. Well, it turns out that each one of these steps has its own enzyme. Enzymes depend on random collisions. In order to find their substrates, their substrates literally have to run into the enzyme. Multiple enzymes of a particular metabolic pathway may be grouped close together in a cell or an organelle to maximize these molecular collisions. In fact, this is one of the reasons why eukaryotic cells have organelles. If we take, for example, the mitochondria will often have several enzymes in a sequence embedded within its membrane. It will also have these smaller compartments so that substrate and enzyme are more likely to collide with each other than would be the case out in the cytoplasm of the cell. This takes us to the end of our discussion of enzymes. Next, we'll start talking about these two major metabolic pathways previously mentioned. Photosynthesis and cellular respiration. Thanks for your attention. See you in the next video.